Hello, it's Simone here with your lunar mood and energy forecast for the week ahead. So last week I did mention that the energy this week was going to be a little bit lighter in mood, and this is mostly due to a Libra focused energy with both Venus moving into Libra and Mercury, which is still in retrograde, shifting from Scorpio into Libra later this week. We, of course, also have Halloween and Samhain, which is on Saturday, and it's also a blue moon. So there's some pretty potent energy that's happening out there in this week. Today, Monday, kicks off with the Waxing Gibbous Moon in the sign of sensitive and intuitive Pisces. So Pisces is all about empathy and compassion. So be sure to have plenty of this for yourself today, especially if you are feeling more emotional than normal, which can happen on a Pisces moon. When the moon is in Pisces, it's a really good time to tap into your creative side and to get a little bit arty, particularly if you do need to soothe your sensitive soul. And this is a great way to harness some of that creative energy that can come up with the waxing gibbous moon phase. You might also find that spending time in water, so think about getting into a pool or going into the ocean or even just a bath if that's all that you can find. It can be really helpful to tap into your intuition. And it's also a really great time for doing things like tarot and oracle card readings or even giving and receiving energy healing such as Reiki. Pisces rules the feet, so this is a good opportunity to go and get a pedicure and just do lots of earthing where you ground your feet into the earth and just let those energies from the earth come up into your body, and it can be really, really good for achieving a state of balance. If you are feeling really sensitive, then my essential oil recommendation to use on Monday and Tuesday when the moon is in Pisces are the blends Chia or even Hope can really help to uplift your spirits. On Wednesday night, the moon will shift into Aries and Venus will be moving into Libra, and Mercury will also go retrograde into Libra. So while the kind of the go-getter Aries moon energy is really, really great to harness in these final few days that we are in, the moon is in before it hits the full moon, the vibes from Venus and Mercury in Libra are going to polarize the usual Aries energy. So it's going to be easier to see things from different points of view, and it's going to bring a much more gentler and balanced vibe than an Aries moon would normally bring. On Thursday and Friday, you can harness the Aries moon energy by allowing yourself to get fired up. And just that's a really good energy to have when you're trying to finish those tasks that you want to get done before the full moon. All those things that you put on your intentions list back on the new moon in Libra a couple of weeks ago. It's really good to get through those. Use that Aries energy to get fired up. Review the things that you had on that list of things to do. Make sure that all of those things are still aligned with what it is that you really want, and make any necessary changes or adjustments to allow you to rise to the challenge. And if there is something that you really want to do that's going to take a little bit more effort than normal, then you should be able to do that on the Aries moon. You might feel more courageous and like even fearless and as you go about doing your things in your business. So be sure to release any kind of excess energy that you might have by really moving your body in a really physical way. Sweat it out. Do something, lots of hardcore cardio, boxing or RPM or something like that, where you can really sweat out all of that energy. And if the Aries moon does cause you to feel a little bit overstimulated, then I would recommend using the essential oil blend Digesten. This is going to really help to assimilate and reduce some of those feelings of overwhelm that can come up. And all you have to do is just drop one or two drops into your hand, you rub your hands, and then you inhale, and that's really going to help to, with any feelings of overwhelm that might be coming up for you. On Saturday, the moon will move into stable and earthy Taurus, and the moon at this time will be almost full. It's officially a full moon on Sunday morning in Australia. In Australian Eastern Standard Time, it's at 1:49 a.m. So on Saturday night, it's pretty much a full moon. The full moon is always a time for us to be releasing. And with this full moon, it's also on Halloween and Samhain. So it's a good time to release any negativity and any of these kind of low vibe traits that you might have, such as fear or greed or anger or jealousy. Get rid of those on this full moon. With the veil between the worlds being thinner at this time, you can really tap into your intuition and connect with your ancestors, connect with your inner self as well, and let your guides to allow you to see yourself from your truest light. The essential oil cinnamon is really beautiful to put on in your diffuser. When you're doing some of this shadow work, it's going to help you to feel really safe and really protected. The Taurus moon is a really good time to also release any issues that you might have around money and your possessions, and just let go of anything that is blocking you in this area. On Sunday, of course, is the official, on Sunday morning, very early Sunday morning, is the official full moon in Taurus. And this marks the completion of the cycle that started back with the Taurus new moon in April. So go back and look at what your intentions were that you set back then in April and see what has come to light over these last 6 months. And you might find that you want to reevaluate and improve on some things in your life. And this is a really good time to also review your budget because Taurus does rule money and possessions. Of course, don't forget to use your My Unstoppable Life journal. I have the full moon mapping section in the journal, which allows you to just go through and you can and use these prompts that I've got in here to map out your what it is that you're going to be releasing on the full moon and to do some of that release work. And this Taurus moon is a wonderful time to get grounded, especially we've got all this Scorpio water energy that's been going on the last couple of weeks. So and because Taurus does rule money and possession, these areas of our life might be illuminated on this moon. So it's a good time to practice gratitude, particularly around these Taurian values of money, possessions and quality of life. And, you know, Taurus moons are the perfect time to practice self-care. It's all about self-care, indulgence, enjoying life, making the most out of every moment that we have. So be sure to spend time with friends and family over the weekend, do things that you really love to do, and just appreciate all of that goodness that you have in your life. You might like to make a little rollerball blend for the Taurus full moon. In this, you can include wild orange, which is going to help you to feel abundant, spikenard, which is really great for feelings of gratitude, and elevation, which of course is going to uplift you and make you feel really good. So apply this over your heart center on the full moon, and it's going to help you to harness some of those Taurian moon vibes. So that is my forecast for the week ahead. Happy full moon over the weekend. Happy Halloween. Happy Samhain. And I will be back again next week. Bye for now.